And welcome back, everyone, to the arena for another exclusive matchup here on Worldwide. Sunday, September the 17th, is the date of Fall Brawl. World Championship Wrestling's next pay-per-view extravaganza as we see the debuting Mad Jack make his way to the ring. Tony, at Fall Brawl, Kevin Nash gets his shot. The title shot that he earned at New Blood Rising when he squares off with the world's heavyweight champion, Booker T. What a strange individual this Mad Jack appears to be. And speaking of strange, part of the Dark Carnival, one of the Freaks in Paint, maybe even the leader of the Freaks in Paint, the man who has had that running rivalry for the past several months with Sting on his way to the ring is Vampiro. And what an interesting matchup this should be involving these two off-the-wall individuals.
Like I tell you, as you look at Mad Jack, just like we talked about at the beginning of this week's telecast, the demon now has dropped out of favor with Vampiro. I don't know what spell Vampiro had over the demon through the bulk of the summertime months, but now the demon has forged his own way, and Vampiro now has turned his attention and his wrath towards the demon. Well, the man we know, Dale Torborg, the demon, that can only spell trouble, because we know what Vampiro will do. He will do the sickest things possible to a human being, and it remains to be seen what's going to happen to the demon.
Need proof positive of that. Just ask Sting. And I'm not exactly sure whether it's an official alliance or not, but you have noticed that as of late, the demon has been watching Sting's back, and I think for the demon's long-term success here in World Championship Wrestling, that is definitely necessary that he's got someone like Sting on his side. Into the corner goes Mad Jack, and Vampiro brings him out by the head, drives him face first with a canvas. Mad Jack quickly to his feet. Vampiro ready, prepared for him, sends him off into the ropes, telegraphed the back body drop, and it was broken up by Mad Jack. Vampiro just pulls him back into the corner, cut him with an elbow, and a very unique drop kick, mule kick style.
No question that Vampiro has turned heads with his bizarre behavior and his barbaric-like tortures of human beings, but the fact is, just like we saw with Crowbar, for all his oddness, the man can go in the ring. He really is talented.
Yeah, just like we mentioned with Crowbar, there's never been a question the wrestling ability of Vampiro to go along with, well, several strange quirks that he may bring to World Championship Wrestling. Mad Jack follows up with one boot to the side, with another one that time between the shoulder blades. Now staking out Vampiro, his opposition again. Boots to the chest, measuring him, caught him with the right hand. Picks up Vampiro with the dreadlocks and then knocks him right back down to the canvas. Mad Jack certainly physically is able to match up quite well with Vampiro. Spin kick took him down.
The fact is, though, is that Vampiro has obviously a lot more ring time, a lot more experience than Mad Jack. And there's an example. Vampiro enabled, let Mad Jack go to the top rope so he could execute this move here.
And when Mad Jack committed himself by going to the top rope, there was only one where to go. And this time, courtesy of Vampiro, it's over the head. Vampiro drove him down to the mat, makes his way over for the cover. Referee Mickey J down for the count, but still something left in the gas tank of Mad Jack because he's able to kick out at two. Now Vampiro back out to the top rope, sets up. Oh, Mad Jack caught him that time right at the belt line or possibly lower with the boot. Brings Vampiro back up to his feet. Mad Jack's going to shoot him off into the ring ropes. Vampiro just pulled his way again. Mad Jack caught him with a low kick, right hand, right to the side of the head. Now Hydra's move on the way. Mad Jack going up to the top. It backfired on him last time. Let's check this one out. Went to the well again by going to the top rope. And Vampiro was prepared. Caught him in a version of a power bomb and drove him directly to the mat.
Sometimes these guys go to the top rope, Michael. I guess it's the thing to do, but it was wrong that time.
Nail in the coffin. That one. Two. Put him away. It's another impressive victory for Vampiro here on WCW Worldwide.